Hey guys, so I just filmed a favorites video and I am on a roll. So I'm going to be showing you my empties, which is basically my trash that I have been accumulating for I don't know how long. So I am going to show you what I have used up. Basically what these empties videos are is I show you what I have used up and I tell you whether I liked it, whether I didn't like it, and whether I will repurchase it or not. Right on into this horrible bag that has been tossed around for I don't know how long. So the first thing that I have is the Frederick Fekkai Glossing Shampoo, and this I hated. It is so weird. It doesn't really cleanse your hair at all. It doesn't gloss your hair at all. It really doesn't do anything. It kind of felt like glue in my hair, and I do not recommend it. I had the conditioner as well that was mediocre. It really didn't do very much, and as you can see from the sticker that I have on it, it was on sale, and it was on sale for a reason. The next thing I have is the Urban Decay All Nighter Spray. This is their old packaging. As you can see, I have had it for a long time. I have since repurchased this. This is absolutely amazing. I really do believe that this really helps keep your makeup on in place. So yep, already bought a new one. Is definitely one of my holy grail items that I really enjoy. The next thing I have is an Ulta shower gel that was given to me around Christmas time. This is Vanilla Fizz. I liked it, nothing to write home about. It was just an ordinary shower gel, smelled kind of like vanilla lemon cake. It has a lemony scent to it, so. The next thing that I have totally brings me back to middle school and middle school locker room, to be precise, because every girl had this scent and it is Love Spell. I used up the shower gel. I really did enjoy it. It brought back so many memories of, you know, being bullied and just girls being really catty, and it was just, middle school is an amazing time, but I'm not holding it against this. I really did enjoy it. Next thing is a Bath & Body Works body lotion, and I liked it. It was just an ordinary, you know, apple smell, nothing too unique. Alright, and I have four mascaras. Three of them are the Maybelline, this one's the Colossal, I have the Falsies, and then also the Mega Plush. These ones I liked. I mean, they weren't, you know, anything really exciting or anything. Actually, I still have some in here, but they're kind of old and I didn't want to mess with my eyes just because I wanted to use them up, so these are going to be tossed. This one I really liked. I actually got this for my wedding. I did wear fake eyelashes, and so this was actually really nice to meld your real lashes into the fake lashes. So I really enjoyed this, but again, it's just too old, so I am tossing it. And this one I absolutely loved. This is the Revlon Lash Potion. And not only is the packaging adorable, the wand and the formula is absolutely amazing. This is really, really big. The formula is really nice, but as you can see, it is really, really gloopy now. I used it for far too long, and so I'm just going to toss this because I actually had a scare with my eye. I actually got like a little bump on my lash line, and so I kind of freaked out and stopped using it. So yeah, I'm definitely paying attention to how long I have mascaras open and how long I'm actually using them on my eye. So the next two things are a couple of foundations. I have the Revlon Colorstay in Buff and the CoverGirl Outlast Stay Fabulous in number 805. I really did enjoy both of these. This one kind of dried my skin out just a little bit. Now that I'm a little bit older, I do kind of get dry patches in areas, and this really clung to them. But if I moisturized beforehand, it wasn't an issue. Just if I was in a hurry and just kind of put it all over, it did cling to dry patches and it felt drying on my skin. And the Revlon Colorstay is a cult favorite for a reason. It stays on for forever. As soon as I am done with a couple of my foundations that I have going currently, I want to repurchase this. I think that it really stands up to a lot of high-end foundations, and I really enjoy it. Primer potions from Urban Decay. I have a zillion of these, and I really enjoy it. It's always been really good to me. I've never had creasing with it, and yeah, definitely recommend it. If you, like myself, collect palettes, you have a ton of these. A couple lip products that I have. One is the Clinique Chubby Stick. I got this as a point perk, and I really liked it. However, I have so many lip products that I will not be repurchasing this anytime soon. However, I really did like the color and the formula. It's really, really nice. And I also have a Revlon Lip Butter in Pink Truffle. This is like the perfect mid-tone brownie pink. I really liked it. And I'm sorry if the color keeps going in and out. The sun is setting, so I apologize. Coconut Body Butter from the Body Shop. Really liked this. It's all gone. I also had a Raspberry Body Butter that was, you know, the regular huge size, and I finished that up. I have so many of these though. I kind of went crazy when they were doing Christmas sales and stuff, so I have a ton of them that I need to use up. Clear mascara / brow gel. Really liked it. As you can see, it is now gray, so that is going in the trash. This I absolutely adore. This is the Maybelline Dream Lumi Touch concealer. This is in the color Radiant. I absolutely love this stuff. Once I kind of, you know, I'm trying to get through some of my stash because I do have a lot of stuff that it's like impossible for one person to use up. So I am trying to, you know, kind of go through my products and not have them go bad before I do. So once I kind of go through some of my concealers, I really do want to repurchase this. This is really, really great for under eyes. It just brightens you up. It, you know, just, it really highlights that area and makes it look really, really nice. I also have a liquid liner. This is from Sephora. It is just their, let's see, long lasting eyeliner. And there are birds fighting outside. This is just a felt tip liner. Absolutely amazing. I really enjoy it. I have their pen liner, which is okay. It's not as opaque black as I would like it to be, but it still really works. However, I do prefer these sort of well liners. I also have this Be Fine night cream that I got in one of my Birch boxes, like I don't know how long ago, but I really do enjoy this, or I did enjoy this. However, I do have a lot of creams, a lot of night creams, day creams, all kinds of creams, so I won't be repurchasing this, but I really did enjoy it. And the last thing is a perfume. This is Viva La Juicy, as I'm sure that you know. This is just really, really great. I have another one that I am currently using. Yeah, I just really like it. I also have a purse spray, so yeah, I've definitely repurchased it and I do enjoy it. So that is it for my empties. I really want to do this again. I think that it would be really kind of cool to see how many things I can go through. I have kind of in the past, because I'm like, oh, I'm not gonna film a video, so I'll just toss it. I've tossed things and now I kind of regret it, but I will go ahead and see what other things that I can use up and report back. I hope you guys enjoy. If you have any questions or comments, or if you have any ideas of what kind of videos you want me to do, I will definitely do them. And yeah, let's have a conversation. If you've used any of these products, definitely let me know. Let me know if you like them or not. So yeah, I am going to go and I will talk to you soon.